What imaging modality would you like to pursue for further diagnosis of appendicitis or right lower quadrant abdominal pain? I would like to point to the audience that if the findings are classic, both historically and physical, there's no need for further imaging studies. However, if you need to get an imaging study, we have a lot of modalities that are available to us: CAT scans, ultrasound, and MRI. Let's visit CAT scans. Clearly, CAT scans introduce radiation to the patient, which is of concern, particularly if the patient has had recent radiation or is pregnant. Modern CAT scanners are multi-slice detectors, which introduce less radiation. Nevertheless, it's not zero. That's why ultrasound has gained some favor recently. Ultrasound is very operator dependent. So if you have a good technician who's experienced in doing ultrasounds for right lower quadrant pain, the results are very helpful and trustworthy. Concurrently, ultrasounds do not give any radiation to the patient and may be a good first diagnostic tool in the young patient who you have very high suspicion of appendicitis. And lastly, don't forget about MRIs. MRIs are particularly helpful for pregnant patients, as both CAT scans introduce radiation, which we don't want for the infant, and the ultrasound may be difficult to obtain useful images. Therefore, we can offer an MRI. Now that you decided the patient needs surgery, how do we prepare the patient for surgery? Well, everybody gets preoperative antibiotics. Specifically, we want to cover enteric content, enteric meaning intestines. In the colon, gram-negatives and anaerobes predominate. This means our antibiotic choice can be a first-generation cephalosporin or fluoroquinolone attached to an anaerobic coverage. Here on the slide, you see ciprofloxacin and metronidazole, which is a classic combination. This is a high-definition image of a laparoscopic appendectomy. Through this trocar, we are looking at the right lower quadrant of the abdomen. In the lower third of the screen, you notice that the appendix is lying horizontally. Laparoscopic appendectomy is now standard of care. The way that we divide the appendix is using a linear titanium stapler. We divide the appendix and detach it from its cecum, as well as taking its blood supply called the mesoappendix. High yield fact. Intraoperatively, even though you were 100% certain that the patient had acute appendicitis, if you're presented with a scenario, you're in the operating room and there's no appendicitis, one should consider some other potential differential diagnosis. In this age group, inflammatory bowel disease is very, very common. Always think about inflammatory disease when the appendix appears normal intraoperatively. How do we care for the patient postoperatively? Well, it depends on if the patient is perforated or non-perforated. In perforated patients, one should consider continuing antibiotics longer than if the patient was not perforated. Advanced diet based on the clinical picture. What does that mean? Has the patient resolved their bowel function, had bowel movements, passing gas? Have their fever trends been downwards? Have their leukocytosis or white blood cell count returned to normal? And remember to counsel the patient that with the perforated appendicitis, they are at a higher risk for developing an intra-abdominal postoperative abscess. This is all different than a patient who has a non-complicated, non-perforated appendicitis. Luckily for me, this is the vast majority of the patients. These patients can usually have their antibiotics discontinue within 24 hours of surgery. We rapidly advance their diet, and they're less likely to have an intra-abdominal postoperative abscess, though not 0%. These patients typically go home within 24 hours of surgery. Some important clinical pearls to keep in mind. Although earlier I said that imaging is not necessary if classic findings in history are present, it may be necessary in patients where the classic history and exam is not present. This is particularly true in women. Again, ultrasound is increasingly used for diagnosis because it gives no radiation to the patient. High yield facts for your examination. If the scenario presents a patient who you're pretty certain has appendicitis, you're in the operating room and yet the appendix appears normal to you, I would recommend that you still remove the appendectomy and do a completion laparoscopic appendectomy. Remember, always consider GYN pathology, particularly in childbearing age women. Thank you very much for joining me on this module on acute appendicitis.